Yo, this shit right here, What's good, y'all? It's a good fight coming up tonight. We got the former WBC IBF light welterweight champ and the former IBF welterweight champ, Devon Alexander, trying to right things, going up against Amir Khan, the former two-time WBA light welterweight champ and the former IBF light welterweight champ. And he himself is trying to get things right, trying to make a statement in the welterweight division so he could be one of the formidable opponents for Floyd Mayweather down the line. Now this fight is going, they're gonna be fighting for Khan's WBC silver welterweight title, which is the same title that Robert Guerrero had that made him the mandatory for Floyd Mayweather's WBC welterweight title. So, therefore, the winner of this fight will be possibly Floyd Mayweather's next opponent, maybe in May or next September. So, these two guys are great. I say it's a 55-45, not a 50-50, 55-45. And I'll tell you which way I'm going 55 with in a minute here. But these two guys are great fighters. Only one of them is elite. And I believe that to be Devon Alexander. Now, the YouTube boxing community and a lot of the people who follow boxing, but they're not really a part of the YTBC, you guys are pissing me off a little bit. I'm a little disappointed in you guys. And the reason being is that you fail to see how good Devon Alexander really is. Devon Alexander is an elite fighter at this division. He was elite at 140, and he is elite at 147. And I don't know if it's because he doesn't have, his record doesn't reflect his power. I don't know what the hell the problem is. It's just same thing with Tim Bradley before he actually beat Pacquiao. And actually, I take that back. Y'all didn't see Tim Bradley as being good until he came back and beat Ruslan Provodnikov in a fight where he didn't fight the way he normally fights. So, does Devon Alexander got to get his motherfucking face knocked off before y'all give him the respect he deserves like Tim Bradley? What's the fucking problem here? Devon Alexander is an elite fighter, okay? This is a hard matchup for Amir Khan. I got to give props to Amir Khan. He fights anybody, anywhere, anytime. He does. Now, I've been waiting for this shit. Since last year, I've been waiting for this fight. When they announced it last year, and then Amir Khan backed out of it because he was trying to, you know, the whole polling thing that Mayweather did, which I think is bullshit, but it was just something to keep you fans excited and have something to talk about. But the whole poll thing he did with Amir Khan and Marcos Maidana, you know what I'm saying? That ruffled Amir Khan's feathers and shit. Thought he was going to get the fight, so he canceled this fight. That shit pissed me off. Even though Mayweather didn't name Khan as his opponent yet, I was still pissed off that he canceled this fight. This is a great fight for Amir Khan to win if he wins. It's a great fight for him. He restakes his claim as one of the top fighters in his division, okay? The whole thing about his chin, granted, Alexander's, like I said, his record reflects or may lead people to perceive that he does not have power, right? But the way that people talk about Amir Khan's chin is that this motherfucker will get knocked out by a fruit fly. You know what I'm saying? So if he beats Alexander, and even better, if he does it easily, there's no fucking excuses. You can't say Amir Khan's a scrub. You can't say he's a bum. You can't say he's a journeyman. You know what I'm saying? You gotta give him his fucking respect. So, this was an excellent fight for Amir Khan last year. The Tim Bradley fight with Amir Khan and Tim Bradley 2 years ago, I wish that shit would have went down. Now, I can't knock Tim Bradley for canceling it because he got a more lucrative opportunity against Manny Pacquiao and he went on to win that fight. So you can't knock him for that. But I wish that fight could have taken place, because we could have seen what Khan was really made of a long time ago against someone who can box from the outside and apply pressure. in the same fight. They can switch it up and apply pressure. Tim Bradley is that type of fighter. Devon Alexander is that type of fighter. We've already seen Khan against somebody who can apply pressure, and that was against Lamont Peterson. By the way, I had Lamont Peterson winning that fight. I don't give a fuck if I'm in the minority or not. Amir Khan pushes off way too fucking much. I'm glad that the ref took away points, because that's all he was doing to try to gain space, because he can't box on his back foot. He's pushing off on Lamont Peterson, loses points, loses the fight by split decision because of the points. Excellent refereeing, excellent call by the judges. Lamont Peterson did win that fight, and it was because he applied pressure. Now, while we're talking about pressure, what do you think Alexander's two losses are? By the way, his record is 26 wins, 2 losses, and 14 knockouts. What do you think Alexander's two losses came from? Pressure. Tim Bradley bullying him on the inside, getting on the inside, leading with the head. And then Sean Porter, who is just absolute 100% pressure. Soon as the fucking bell rings, this motherfucker runs at his opponent. You know what I'm saying? Like he's a damn running back or some shit. Like he's a linebacker trying to get to the quarterback. That's how Sean Porter fights. 100% nonstop pressure. That's what beats Devon Alexander. Nobody has ever outboxed Devon Alexander, amateurs or pros. But that's the only thing Khan knows how to do, right? So basically, we're going into this fight hoping that, if you're a Khan fan anyway, hoping that Amir Khan can do something that no other fighter has been able to do against Devon Alexander, and that's outbox him. Okay? Amir Khan has absolutely no ability on the inside. When he gets on the inside, all he's, if he's not tying up, he's trying to push off, create space so he can throw that laser jab. That's what Khan does, man. That's his game. From the outside, using his hand speed, throwing 4, 5, 6 punch combinations from the outside, circling, doing it again. Not backing up. Listen to what I'm saying. Circling. There's a difference between backing up and circling. Okay? When he's backing up, he has trouble throwing those combinations. And that's how Lamont Peterson was getting to him, because he was making him back up. He was cutting off the ring. In the beginning of that fight, Lamont Peterson was trying to outbox him. He was like, shit, this motherfucker's too fast. I can't outbox him. I got to cut the ring off. I got to apply pressure. You know what I'm saying? And that's what the fuck he did. That's how he took over the second half of that fight. Man, I'm tell you right now, I couldn't wait for this fight. I cannot wait to see this fight tonight. The way Alexander wins this fight, apply pressure. Smother him. Alexander's fought Lucas Matisse. He's fought Juan Urango. I don't even need to go any further than that. Junior the Hitter Witter. I don't even need to go further than that. These guys all had power. Junior Witter was not a major power puncher, but he was a guy that knocked down Tim Bradley in their fight. So he had some power. Okay? He's been hit by these guys. And that Lucas Matisse fight, in that 10th round, he was getting hit by some good shots. He got knocked down by a straight right hand, I think in the 3rd or 4th round, I can't remember, don't quote me, but early in the fight, got knocked down by a straight right hand by Matisse while he was circling, lost his balance, got right back up, ended up probably, came close to winning the round. He lost the round because he got knocked down, but if he wouldn't have got knocked down, he probably would have won that round, because he did well after that knockdown. He has a chin. Alexander has a chin. Amir Khan has susceptible power. Very fast hands. Not that great footwork, though. His footwork is average. And honestly, in my opinion, Amir Khan is somewhat one-dimensional, because he has to fight you from the outside, and that's the only way he can use his hand speed. He does have power to go with that hand speed, though. But it's not, I don't think it's enough power to hurt Devon Alexander, to keep him from coming forward. It wasn't enough to keep Lamont Peterson from coming forward. And we all know what happened to Lamont Peterson when he fought Lucas Matisse. So that's a testament to the fact that Amir Khan doesn't have the power to keep a motherfucker off him. But he does have the power, if you decide to outbox him, to keep your ass guessing. That's the type of power Amir Khan has. So, but in this fight, he does have the reach advantage. Amir Khan is 5'8 and a half. He has a 71-inch reach. Devon Alexander's 5'8 and a half. He has a 70-inch reach. So, it's written on paper. If Devon Alexander tries to outbox him from the outside, he's most likely going to lose the fight. This shit is just like the prediction I made with Chris Algieri and Manny Pacquiao. The strategy for Alexander is just this crystal clear, just as crystal clear as it was for Chris Algieri. Don't try to fight him from the outside. Get on the inside. Chris Algieri's was opposite. Don't go on the inside. Fight him from the outside. It's just as crystal clear. Okay? For Amir Khan to win, the strategy to beat Alexander, the blueprint is there, but that's not Amir Khan's fighting style. So he has to do something different. But you have to play into what his fighting style is. You can't tell him to do something that he's not accustomed to doing. Okay? Amir Khan is, I believe, 28 years old. He's not going to do anything different at this point in his career. He's going to do exactly what he's always been doing. He's going to have to throw 100 punches around. That's my key for Amir Khan. He has to stay active. He has to keep the jab in Devon Alexander's face. Anything Devon Alexander does, Amir Khan has to come back with something. If Devon Alexander's throwing a 3-4 punch combination, Amir Khan has to do the same fucking thing without getting on the inside, if you can understand what I'm saying. Try to make Devon Alexander fight you from the outside. Try to get him to do that. You have to throw combination after combination after combination, 100 punches around, get in, get out. That's what he has to do. Keep your back off the ropes, okay? Don't let Devon Alexander bully you. Don't let him make you think that you're under a hell of a lot of pressure. Keep your head. Keep your straight punches flowing. You can win this fight. By the way, Khan's record is 29 wins, 3 losses, and 19 knockouts. Of his 3 losses, he was knocked out twice. Once by Brutus Prescott in the first round, the other one by Danny Garcia in the 4th round. Alexander has enough power that if he touches Amir Khan's chin the right way, he could put him down. I'm predicting there's going to be at least one knockdown in this fight. It can go either way, but I think somebody's going to get caught. At least somebody's going to get wobbled. There's going to be a point in this fight where we're like, oh shit, he hit that motherfucker clean. There's going to be a point in this fight where we're all going to say that. Devon Alexander has excellent foot speed, excellent hand speed. He tends to plant his feet when sticking the jab and the straight combination. Watch for that uppercut on the inside. When he gets on the inside, because I know he will, when he gets on the inside of Amir Khan, he's going to use that uppercut. Look for that. Also, look for the lazy right hook. He's a southpaw, so it's a lead right hook, but it's lazy. Makes the opponent pretty much respect that right hook. Then he comes down the pipe with a straight left. Look for that combination. Like I said before, his record doesn't reflect his power. But if you watch the Lucas Matisse fight, we all know Lucas Matisse, against boxers, he's a pressure fighter. Smart boxers like Devon Alexander, he's a pressure fighter. He was applying pressure. Devon Alexander was sticking him. Kept throwing punches and was sticking him. It nullified Matisse's pressure. There's only one reason for that. These motherfuckers aren't thinking in their head, oh shit, I got hit. I just lost some points on the scorecard. They're not thinking that. What they're thinking is, oh shit, I got hit. That shit kind of hurt. There was one point in the early rounds, Devon Alexander landed. Actually, he did the lazy lead hook, the lazy lead right hook, and came with the straight left hand. That shit wobbled Matisse. Now, Matisse has got a nice chin, too. And that combination, because Matisse didn't see that straight left hand coming, it wobbled him. So, don't think Alexander ain't got no fucking power. He has enough power to hurt Amir Khan based on the chin that most of these boxing fans are based on the rating that they give Amir Khan's chin. He could hurt him, and he could possibly knock him out. I don't think that'll happen, but he can. Okay? Amir Khan's got to be smart, and he's got to stick to the game plan, man. He's got Virgil Hunt in his corner. That was the whole point of getting him, to make him grounded, more grounded, stick to the game plan. But that's what he's got to do. And he's got to do it from the outside. I mean, it's just crystal clear. What's my prediction? I think this is going to be a close, unanimous decision win for Devon Alexander. I'm talking like 115-113. I wouldn't be surprised if it was majority's decision or split decision. But I think that the fact that Amir Khan is so one-dimensional and Devon Alexander has a chin, he has great footwork, he can bounce in and out, he has great hand speed. The only problem is he doesn't commit too much on his punches because he's more reliable on his hand speed. But when he plants his feet, that's when he starts to commit on his punches. And I think if he gets Amir Khan anywhere near the ropes and he can plant his feet there and he starts committing on his punches, that's where he's really going to hurt Khan. If Khan decides he wants to box him or fight with him, given Devon Alexander the ability to use his 70-inch reach and Alexander's planet, he's going to hurt Khan there. There's so many different ways that Devon Alexander can actually hurt Khan in this fight. And I think we're going to see that. I think Amir Khan is going to do well boxing from the outside in a few rounds, maybe early in the fight. But he's going to get complacent, and that's what he does, man. He gets complacent. He starts doing stupid shit. Even in the Luis Collazo fight, man, all he had to do was stay on the outside. Luis Collazo's been washed up for a long time. Yes, he knocked out Victor Ortiz, but that's another washed up motherfucker. That ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? So he still was letting Luis Collazo get to him. You see what I'm saying? He's letting Luis Collazo get to him. He's not. Your point, your fighting style, you box and you circle. You don't let the motherfucker get to you. And he was still getting to him, and you're still seeing Amir Khan pushing off. I hope to God, if he pushes off in this, well, actually, I don't even want to say if, when Amir Khan's pushing off in this fight, because Devon Alexander's going to get there. He's going to get to him. When Amir Khan is pushing off, I hope to God they take off points. That shit is fucking illegal, and I cannot stand it. That's some pussy-ass shit. Pushing off. Fight your way out. Sting this motherfucker. Don't let him get close. Don't push him. That's some pussy shit, man. I hope they take points away from Khan if he does it too much. So, that also could be an issue. But I think the fact that Devon Alexander, he's a smart fighter, and he has a lot of different anomalies going for him that go against Amir Khan. Like I said, his hand speed, foot speed, his ability to apply pressure. He can also keep Amir Khan guessing by applying pressure, right? And then switching it up sometimes. Now, I think he needs to apply pressure majority of the fight, but he can switch it up and kind of try to box him from the outside, kind of confuse Khan. He won't know what the fuck he's trying to do. He can do that as well. Too many different ways Devon Alexander can win this fight. So I think that will be enough for the judges to see it his way, all three judges to see it his way, but it'll be close, because there will be some points in the fight where Amir Khan is doing his thing. So let me know what you think. I can't wait to see this fight. Devon Alexander wins. I can't wait to see him fight Floyd Mayweather. Let me know what y'all think. Do what you do underneath the video, but be real. This is real talk for real fans. One.